Black Report, Wikipedia article audio. The Black Report was a 1980 document published by the Department of Health and Social Security in the United Kingdom, which was the report of the Expert Committee into Health Inequality chaired by Sir Douglas Black. It was demonstrated that although overall health had improved since the introduction of the welfare state, there were widespread health inequalities. It also found that the main cause of these inequalities was economic inequality. The report showed that the death rate for men in social class V was twice that for men in social class I, and that gap between the two was increasing, not reducing as was expected. The Black Report was commissioned in March 1977 by David Ennals, Labor Secretary of State, following publication of a two-page article by Richard G. Wilkinson in New Society, on December 16, 1976, entitled Dear David Ennals. The report was nearly ready for publication in early 1979. Commissioning. Impact. In the general election on May 3, 1979, the Conservatives were elected. The Black Report was not issued until 1980 by the Conservative government. The Black Report was published on August bank holiday with only 260 copies made available on the day for the media. The foreword, by Patrick Jenkin, rejected the view that the causes of health inequalities are so deep-rooted that only a major and wide-ranging program of public expenditure is capable of altering the pattern. He made it clear that additional expenditure on the scale which could result from the report's recommendations, the amount involved could be upwards of £2 billion a year, is quite unrealistic in present or any foreseeable economic circumstances, quite apart from any judgment that may be formed of the effectiveness of such expenditure in dealing with the problems identified. The report had a huge impact on political thought in the United Kingdom and overseas. It led to an assessment by the Office for Economic Cooperation and Development and the World Health Organization of health inequalities in 13 countries. Professor Claire Bambra in 2016 compared the report with the later Akison report and the subsequent report by Michael Marmot. The Akison report was released into a more favorable climate than either. She said that at least between 1997 and 2003, health policy across the UK reflected some of the ideas set out in the Black and Akison reports. There was a consistent emphasis on the need to tackle the social and economic determinants of health inequalities, as well as a commitment to employing cross-cutting government policies to tackle health inequality. Most importantly, by 2004, national targets to reduce health inequalities were also introduced, with a focus on life expectancy and infant mortality rate. A series of initiatives were introduced: health action zones, healthy living centres, health improvement programmes, and the New Deal for Communities. But, perhaps because of these initiatives, from 2004 to 2007, public health policy moved away from social and economic determinants and instead focused more on health services and lifestyle behaviours. The health inequalities targets were abandoned across the UK in 2011. The effect of policy in reducing health inequality was modest. Penguin Books published a shortened version of the Black Report in 1982, making it widely available. The Whitehall Report, published in 1987, came to the same conclusions as the Black Report, as did the Akison report later in 1998, and the Marmot review in 2010. Related publications.